With me now from Argentina, I have Fernanda Bejel. Welcome.
Bonjour, merci.
Ms. Bejel, the research project that you and your colleagues are working on with the GFM Sciences is called A Comparative Study of Gender Inequalities in Scientific Publishing and Its Impact in Career Building in Brazil and Argentina. Will you please describe the focus and key elements of your research project?
Yes, of course. This project is based on a previous network, a research network that exists since 2004, and we work on Argentina, Brazil, and Chile. And so on these previous results, we could build hypotheses related with the effect of the hierarchies established between sexes in collaborative networks, in academic publishing, and the impact of these gender asymmetries in the career building in each of our countries. And so particularly, we're interested in how scientific recognition is built and what is the impact of gender asymmetries in academic publishing.
And I know that the project just started in October, but do you have some findings that you can already share with us?
Yes, because our previous studies can show us many gender asymmetries in the concrete publishing realm and research collaboration that are the basis of this project. For example, for Argentina and Brazil, if we take both population of researchers in Argentina, the national agency is called CONICET, in Brazil is the CNPq, we have studied the complete publishing production of all these researchers, I mean men and women, and the comparison shows that in average, men publish in the total trajectory, in this case, 38 articles, while women publish 28. This means that there is a productivity gap between men and women. But also, if you compare, if you put in at work language, which is very important in our countries, we are non-hegemonic countries, and our main language is Spanish and Portuguese. So to write in English has to do with many social and capital, social and cultural capital issues that are very important in the gender differences. Also, you can find that, for example, for the same population, men publish 28 articles in English and women 18. So there is a productivity gap, not only in general, but also in English writing. And this has a direct,
And why is it important to have knowledge about this?
Because if we can observe the gender asymmetries that we find in academic publishing, we're going to be able to understand how the academic hierarchies are built and how scientific recognition is mostly related to men and not to women, and the difference of the prestige building that we can find in this different trajectories divided by sex.
So what is that? What is it that you hope will be the future impact of your research findings?
Yes, particularly to observe these gender asymmetries in academic publishing and research networks has to do with the idea of offering our public agencies, the CONICET and the CNPq, information in order to change the policies of research assessment. Because for tenure and for promotion, these gender asymmetries normally are not considered. And so if we can find, if we can observe the differences, for example, related in productivity, I mean related, for example, for the activities of care that women normally are facing more than men, we can understand that it is important to make differences in the research assessment policies between women and men. So these results should help in a reflection for these two institutions in terms of the difference of the gender asymmetries.
And when can we expect to hear more from you? When will you have results?
Well, the research project just started now at the 1st of October, but we're planning to finish the research in a year. So in next October 2021, we hope to have our results to show everybody.
We look forward to hearing more about your project and wish you the best of luck. Thank you very much for sharing the project with us.
Thank you very much. Thanks to all.